Good evening, everyone. We are so glad to see you here tonight, and I know that you are in anticipation of hearing that from Course. And we're so glad they can be with us here tonight. About a year and a half ago, I made a phone call, and I wanted to know when I could get them to come here. And here they are, a year and a half later, and we are really looking forward to having them here. Would you stand with me, please, and we'll have a word of prayer, and then we'll turn the time over to the Course. Father, thank you for this day, and thank you for allowing everyone to be able to be here tonight and bringing them here safely. I know, Lord, that you have a real blessing in store for us, and I ask you bless the Course as they sing, as they share. May there be a real time of refreshing our minds and just being encouraged, and especially this time of the year, Lord, we know that you came as a babe, but yet we worship you as our Father, as our King, and we want to do that tonight. And I pray this in your name. Amen. You may be seated. Antrim Course, we're so grateful you're here, and we turn the time over to you.
Step down into darkness, open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you, hope of a life spent with you. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. And I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross.
To see my sin upon that cross. I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin upon that cross.
Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God.
What a joy it is to be in Stark County. This is where I had my beginnings, for those of you who don't know, back in 69. It's cold up here. I'm kind of glad we live a little further south. There is usually a little difference in the temperature, not much. We're going to sing about an unusual birth tonight. I'm sure some of you mothers have some unusual birth stories. In fact, my grandpa, Andy J. Miller, which some of you drink coffee with at McDonald's, I understand. In 1950, about this time of the year, November, I guess it was, the year my uncle Robert was born, Bob Miller, you might know him as. He was born in Chardon, Ohio, in Joggie County. I guess that was Joggie County. And it was raining when Grandpa, I just heard a story again today. It was raining when he took him to the hospital, when he took Grandma to the hospital. And it was raining when he came home, turning to snow after Bob was born. And it rained, that was on a Thursday, Thanksgiving Day. It snowed Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Some of you look like you remember this storm. And when Grandpa went out to measure the snow between the shop and the house, he put the ruler down and it said 36 inches of snow. Well, by Monday, Grandpa was good and ready to see Grandma and his new, brand new little boy. And so he hitched up the horse and sleigh. And it was about a 6 or 8 mile drive. And he drove the sleigh to the hospital, kicked the snow away from the parking meter, and tied the horse to the parking meter. And he told me today he didn't pay the quarter because there was no other traffic around. Isn't that a good story? Grandma said she, when he came in, how was that? She heard him coming down the hall. There were not too many other men around those days, that day. That's an unusual birth story. Wow. But what an amazing story that the Word, the Bible says, became flesh. And I personally believe that the spoken Word of God became flesh. God manifested in the flesh. I had one old man come up to me today at a program. He gripped my arm and he said, just explain to me how that the Holy God could become born, enter a virgin's womb. And he had tears in his eyes. He was so moved by this powerful story. Tonight as we sing, I hope that we can encourage each other, friends and relatives. It's just good to see you all here. Let's have a good, fun time together.
Baptist crying in the wilderness, I baptize you with water, oh. But one is coming who will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire.
You hear the voice crying in the wilderness. That's the way that it's done.
shuffle and the ring of the donkey's feet, and the king lay hid.
And every voice. back in the throne room of heaven, plans were being made to announce the birth of God's Son on earth. Michael the archangel had just finished describing his great heavenly display of comets and falling stars. Gabriel went on with his musical plans, a great angelic choir of tens of thousands of voices, tuned with heaven's finest and latest harmonies, ready to serenade the earth. God interrupted their conversation. "No," he said, "that's not really what I had in mind. I'd planned a small gathering in Bethlehem, actually. We don't need all the trimmings." "But all my stars," said Michael, "what will I do with them?" "And my music," Gabriel added. Just then, Jesus stepped through the pearly gates and out onto the red carpet of time, started down the stairway of stars. Michael pled, "Father, let us do something. He can't go unannounced." "Well, all right," God said. "Gabriel, a few angels. Michael, just one star."
Oh.
breakdown, according to your paper. Is that right, Lord?